Hey everyone, if you're buying some new RAM, you might see the RAM says it's AMD compatible, but if you've got an Intel CPU and motherboard, does that mean that you can't use that particular RAM stick on your system? Well, the short answer is it should work fine, but it's not guaranteed, especially at the very higher speeds, and here's why. You know when you plug in a new graphics card and you haven't got the display drivers yet, what happens on your system is that everything's really low resolution and a little bit blurry, and then you actually install the display drivers and suddenly everything kicks to life and looks really good. That's due to a base sort of display compatibility layer, where effectively the graphics card and the system actually says, yes, we can display something, even if we don't know too much about the specifics of the GPU because we haven't got the drivers yet, we can still display something and then allow the user to actually go and get the drivers. And RAM kind of works the same way, because you've got the JEDEC who set certain base clock speeds. So for example, on DDR5, you might have RAM that always runs at 4800 MHz, which is a bit annoying if you've bought like a 6000 MHz RAM stick and then it doesn't seem to run at that speed. But you know, basically those RAM speeds are the base compatibility ones that are set out. They are guaranteed to work. But what then happens is obviously you might want a RAM stick that goes above 4800 MHz. So what do you do? Well, what actually happens is those RAM sticks that say they are, you know, AMD compatible or AMD Expo, they were actually tested by the RAM maker to actually make sure that they tend to work at those higher marketed speeds, such as 6000 MHz, when they put in an AMD system. And the way that they kind of do this is that they package up all of the data about the RAM and how it runs, and they put it in something called an AMD Expo profile. And then when you go into your BIOS, you can often actually enable AMD Expo, and then your RAM just kicks into life and it starts running at like 6000 MHz or 8000 MHz, you know, whatever RAM stick you bought. That should actually happen, assuming then that your system, you know, starts up and goes through the memory training process, and you know, the motherboard and the CPU's memory controller does actually sort of agree things properly with the RAM. It's not completely guaranteed, but that should work. But what's not as guaranteed is if you go out and buy an AMD, you know, compatible RAM stick, and it doesn't mention anything about Intel XMP, and then you put it in an Intel system, it's not then guaranteed to actually run at the advertised speeds. And that's because if that RAM stick only mentions AMD, that RAM stick maker has only tested it on AMD systems and only packaged up the AMD Expo profile. They haven't packaged things up for Intel, which is called the XMP profile. So in that case, yeah, if you buy like an 8000 MHz RAM stick, super fast RAM stick, and then put in your Intel system, it's not guaranteed to work. I mean, it might work, and certainly I've bought Intel RAM that doesn't mention anything about AMD, and then I've got it working fine in an AMD Ryzen based system. I have got that working, but it's just not guaranteed to work. And especially with DDR5, what you tend to notice is that two sticks of 16 gig is kind of the sweet spot. Anything above that means that, you know, your RAM stick might struggle a little bit more. So if you're hoping to have like 128 gigabytes of DDR5 RAM run really fast on an Intel system and the RAM sticks are optimized for AMD, you might be out of luck then. But if you've got those two sticks of 16 gig, it's probably more likely that it will work, especially if you have a good motherboard. So that kind of wraps everything up, but if you have any further questions, please leave them in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.